Episode 3 of our 510 game is about to begin, Grant, and let's not forget about the giveaway. We, of course, are going to be picking one hand and the winner of that hand. If you include that with the winner of the giveaway hand from the other three episodes of this session, you tweet that us, you are going to win one dash, or at least you'll be entered into a random drawing to win one dash, Grant.
If that was confusing because Jonathan did an amazing job at
that. I was excited, though.
Check out the description of the video because it has more details. Yeah. Meanwhile, Mitzif has a big hand here.
So, you know, Action Aaron has a pretty good hand, too.
Yep. He's not folding. I imagine Blake won't fold either. Blake just won a big pot. The last hand of the last episode against Digital Dan, Queens against Jacks, played it strange.
Action Aaron calling really makes it a lot easier for Blake to call. Not only is he closing the action, but now you get a much deeper stack in there with a hand like Ace-5 suited, which, you know, can make a big hand.
Well, he flops a 5. Aaron flops a flush draw, and Mitzif has an overpair. This is a... I don't think Blake's going to end up being in this hand too much longer, no. But the other two guys are going to clash.
Well... Action Aaron definitely can't fold, and once he calls, oh, is he going to raise or is he going
to
call?
Looks like a call to me.
Is Blake going to call or not? He's got second pair. He's rarely going to be good here, but it's possible Mitzif could have a hand like Ace-King, and he could have the best hand right now.
But what does Aaron have then?
He could have diamonds.
He does, but...
He could also have a 5.
Blake's equity is not great against Aaron's hands.
Especially against both the hands. Yeah. I think this is a good fold for sure.
I agree. It's a big pot already.
Yep. Let's see if a... scary card comes. Not really.
Slightly scary, like Aaron has 5-6 in his range.
Sure, but not. Aaron has a lot of jacks and a lot of diamonds and a lot of pocket pairs and a lot of things that aren't 5-6.
And Mitzif is not giving Aaron quite the right price to call here if he thinks he just has naked flush draw, but he might think he has overs as well.
I think as Action Aaron, it's very reasonable to think a king or a queen is good if you hit it.
Yeah.
So, also being in position as well, I think you're supposed to call this. Although it sucks, because you're going to brick a fair amount of the time. As we see, Action Aaron only has 16% equity.
Yep.
Not super great. Those dash glasses look good, though.
They look pretty good. I'm surprised he can see. It looks like he's trying to see something. He's making what is, in practice, the correct fold there.
Yeah.
Against two kings, that's the correct fold.
Yeah. Maybe he just decided Mitzif isn't going to fire again very often with a hand like Ace-King or Ace-Queen. That could be true. It's hard to know.
Yeah, but he could be against Ace-Jack, and he's got the right odds against Ace-Jack.
But is Mitzif going to 3-bet Ace-Jack that often?
We've seen Mitzif make some light 3-bets in the past, that's for sure.
We have.
Not in this session so much, but we've definitely seen it.
You're right. You're right. It's hard to know. That's a reasonable fold at a minimum.
Yeah, I agree. It's kind of a close spot.
Yep. There's that dash digital cash case. We haven't mentioned the giveaway yet.
I don't think we mentioned the giveaway, John.
Have we mentioned it? Because that's something people should know about.
You should want the free money. That's what you should want.
If you don't know what I was talking about, the description is in the description, actually. We explain it in the description of this video. You can go down and check it out. Dan and BMW Blake with hands.
Both limping. Terminator with not as much of a hand going to raise.
Yep.
55. He's going to terminate.
It's not unreasonable to raise this hand.
It's a little loose.
Okay.
Snuggy's not going to fold.
Got to expect we're usually going to see a 3-bet out of Snuggy here. Looks like he's measuring one out. Question is, will this just end the hand? Looks like it's a big one.
I think it will just end the hand unless somebody else picks up a hand.
255.
255, that is a very large 3-bet.
Oh, yeah.
Blake cannot call.
I can't imagine anyone calling here. Jeremy's thinking about it, but as you can see, he's also pretty short.
Yeah, both of these guys are relatively short here.
This is not the hand you want to call with out of position for another $200.
Even suited would be a fold here with the stack to pot ratio.
Right. We have to have pretty good implied odds to consider calling. We certainly don't. I think Terminator played that one pretty well. I think his raise is fine.
It's all right.
I think his fold is good.
I think his fold is great. Very proud.
Yeah. Someone has to be.
Why?
His parents have issues with him and what he's done, his accomplishments.
I hope that's not true because that's, you know, messed up, dude.
Yeah, I hope it's not true also now that I say it.
Obviously.
Because that would be, if he watches this, is he going to, you know, either be upset or think, who told? Who told him? They all told me. They couldn't wait to share Terminator.
You're messed up, man. You're a messed up person.
You know, we got a lot of free time.
What
a lot of free time.
Digital Dan is looking 6-5 off under the gun because I don't know. And Terminator is limping 9-7 off, plus one, because I don't know.
This is some surprising things are happening right now. Not going to lie.
We got a limp fest now.
Digital Dan, same hand as Brandon Can 2, except worse.
Somebody could make a joke about two flush draws right now, but I would prefer they didn't.
Okay.
Wow. Somehow they both flop two pair. Look at that. Nobody has a queen, though.
Yep.
So Terminator's got a gut shot.
Cantu is going to...
It's a surprising check from Digital Dan, by the way.
I mean, I think he was trapping? I don't know. I don't know what he was doing. He's almost always ahead, right?
So Snuggy's going to call with King Jack of Hearts. He doesn't
two back doors.
Two back doors, yeah.
Closing the action.
Well, I don't think Snuggy's going to win this one.
No, if Snuggy calls again, it's going to be problematic, but I can't imagine.
It's going to be great for Cantu and Digital Dan because there's no other way they're making any money.
Yep. Cantu, I expect to continue here. Yep. He's going to try and get value out of a queen, or if someone has the case six, Digital Dan does have that six, but... You know, doesn't matter because they have the same hand.
It's a great spot to continue.
The question is, what does Digital Dan do? Is he going to find a call, or is he going to make the raise now? Because you got to believe he's thinking about raising.
Just calls. So he doesn't want to chase a queen away. If Cantu had something like king-queen, he might fold to a raise.
I agree. I think this is a good just call.
Unfortunately for both of these players, they're going to be very disappointed when they see their opponent's hand.
Well, yeah. You know, they're going to be glad the other guy doesn't have queen-six, because I assume they're going to get into a raise fest right about now. Digital Dan going to donk this. We've seen him do this before. He always seems to have it when he takes this line.
So Cantu will either move in. Yeah, the stack to pot looks like it's a move in for Cantu.
It'd be a shocking not move in. I mean, he's hoping now Digital Dan just made a straight, right?
Yep, that'd be great.
So it's a very easy move in.
He's trying to make it look hard.
Yep. What do I do? This is a tough spot. Huh.
The only thing he's really losing to is...
Queen six.
Yeah, but Dan's not going to limp that even though he didn't limp 6-5 off. I imagine.
Queen, queen?
Yeah, queen, queen. Dan does slow play big pairs sometimes.
Whatever. If Cantu does move in and he gets insta-called, and they both see that nothing exciting happened. Seriously, how does Digital Dan have 6-5 there? Under the gun.
Unsuited.
So weird. But we talk about him being, you know, the tightest, one of the tightest players, and yet then he limps 6-5
well,
off
he does,
under the gun.
He does watch all of these Poker Time episodes, so maybe he's trying to tell us to shove it.
Yeah, you know what? He doesn't like people when they give limitations. You may recall not long ago he made a big play on Snuggy.
Yeah.
He flop with that 4-deuce when Snuggy insta-folded queens.
Yep. He also doesn't like the limitations of the atmosphere. Are you aware that he is the first person to enter space, walk around a little bit, have a tea party, come back to Earth?
When you say unmanned, what do you mean?
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Without shuttle. He was just one.
Unshuttled?
Unshuttled, yeah. He was just in his special digital suit that he created.
I was going to say, and that's why they call him Digital Dan, yeah.
I kind of bungled that.
Yeah, you know what? It was probably better the way it went. Here's Wonka.
As you say, they're not all first-round picks.
That's right.
Wonka with a very nice hand, and everybody is afraid of Wonka's range because he is probably tighter than Digital Dan.
He
would never limp 6-5 off under the gun. That's for sure.
Pre-flop, he's got the tightest ranges for sure.
Yeah.
Also, you know, another way to put it would be the most reasonable ranges.
That would be another way to put it, although we do see him make some very tight folds that I think might be unreasonable some of the time.
I think what he's trying to do is just stay out of close situations where he can lose a lot of money. I think he's always trying to avoid that, you know, not be in marginal spots because he feels like he doesn't have to be in this game. And that's proven to be correct so far for him.
Yeah.
He's often gotten his money in extremely well throughout Poker Time cash games that we've seen him play.
Right. Like, for example, this is near the bottom of his under-the-gun range, probably, and that's not the case for any other player.
I would guess he'd open king-10 suited.
Yeah.
But probably not king-10 off.
No, I don't think he would ever open king-10 off under
the gun. Is he opening king-jack off? Probably not.
Probably
right?
not.
So there you go. There you go, right near the bottom.
And he gets called by 8-5 and... Oh, no, not 8-5.
8-deuce.
8-deuce and jack-9.
Yep, jack-9 reasonable.
Yep.
8-deuce, different.
Not as reasonable.
A different kind of reason.
It is suited.
Yep.
Maybe Aaron can't see through the glasses.
Well, I'll tell you what he can see is that he has the best hand right now. He knows that.
Because obviously if you flop any pair with 8-deuce, you're always good against the under-the-gun raiser.
You know how when you play poker and some guy, after the hands are exposed, says, I knew I had you.
Yep.
And it's like, well, you didn't know that, actually, because you can't know. Wonka going to make an easy fold. That is a horrific flop for his range compared to everyone else's.
Yep.
And simple fold for Wonka there.
I always find it very funny, and mostly happens in tournaments when I'll raise or somebody at the table will raise the same amount they always raise, and a guy makes a play, and I end up having ace-king and calling off, and he says, I knew you didn't have a pair.
Right.
It's like, how? How did you know that?
It's probably, you know, your eye twitching.
Yeah,
you do a lot of that. You actually, your eyes twitch in Morse code. You didn't know that?
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's really easy to put you on a hand.
Well, that explains a lot because, I mean, you hear that stuff, right, Jonathan?
Of course I hear that stuff.
Like, you raise the same amount you would have raised with aces or tens or anything with ace king. They move in, you call. They're like, I knew you didn't have a pair.
A guy once check raised me all in at a big spot in a tournament when I had two aces in my hand, and it was a king high board, and I called instantly, and he said, I knew you didn't have a king, as if he was happy and proved something. It's like, I had better than a king. What are you talking about?
Well, you know
anyway.
Who doesn't have a pair? Action Aaron. Digital Dan does have a pair and decides just to call on the button.
He's going to bring in Wonka and possibly Terminator.
Terminator's already called. He's already called.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You're right.
Wonka's
going to call now as well. He could have knocked out Wonka and Terminator. Actually, would have knocked out everyone. Digital Dan likes to play this differently than most people, these big
pairs. He plays his big pairs slower than everybody else in the game, for sure. And
he does flop best.
It's a scary flop for him, but he does flop best.
The good news for him is he's got position on the world, so when they all check to him, it's a pretty easy bet.
Yep.
You certainly don't want to just give a free card to the world here. You don't know what you're trying to avoid. There's a lot of cards that are scary.
The nightmare would be getting check raised by Wonka here.
Yep. Instead, everyone's going to fold. Action Aaron folding the gutter.
So Dan wins a little bit more than he would have had he 3-bet there.
Yeah, that's true. He wins another $45, but he also equity wise probably gave up a fair amount of so I don't know if that was good or not, but it's an interesting thing the way he plays with those big pairs, where sometimes he'll limp with them, sometimes he'll 3-bet them or 4-bet them too.
I mean, he does implement some balance with those big pairs, which most people don't. Most people are just raising with them.
Remember, we actually saw him called 4-bet tens against Mitsuf, and another one, and Mitsuf folded ace king pre-flop.
Well, Dan was under the gun.
I mean, I didn't know that could be in his four betting range.
So hey, speaking of queen six under the gun, remember a couple hands ago when we were worried as
that's right
Cantu that Dan might have that? Well, I guess.
Well, Mitsuf raised
Mitsuf
it.
Can have it. Well, yeah.
But still.
And Aaron with the dominating king six, obviously calling.
And Blake with the dominating diamonds.
Yeah.
Terminator has an actual reasonable hand here.
So does Blake.
Yeah, of course. Snuggy has to call in the big blind. Well, he doesn't have to, but it's.
That's the type of hand you could fold in this spot.
You could, but the pot odds are outrageous and you're closing the action.
I agree.
And look.
You got the backdoor nut flush draw.
I mean, come on. That's like you're a kid in a candy store. They got more Baby Ruths than you know what to do with.
It's like the Fountains of Babylon, man.
It is just like that. I was going to say that, but you beat me to it.
I know.
The next thing I was going
to
say was weird.
I had to get there before you did.
It was impressive.
We got Blake betting with ace three of diamonds. He's got the gut shot.
Snuggy's
going to call. I mean, he does have...
He likes calling with back doors, I guess, because I got nothing else.
Yeah, he is a mixed game player. He plays a lot of mixed games.
Yeah.
And some of those flop mixed games, back doors come into play a little bit more.
Well, Snuggy's got a great chance to win this hand now.
Yes, he really does.
Although the problem with him is he's first to act. So he's checking. This is a good time to put in a raise if you're Snuggy, I think.
Blake continuing to bet on the club, by the way, is a bit dangerous.
Yep. Looks like Snuggy's going to call.
This is going to go check on the river so often, and Snuggy's going to get to win with ace 7 high.
Well, let's see if Blake decides to bet the river or not.
It is a chop.
We've seen him. He does check it. You're right. And it is going to be a chop. What a lucky card. There are a lot of cards that were going to chop it, though.
Yeah.
Also, aces and sevens weren't going to be so good, nor were clubs for Blake.
Missed a bet.
Also, other cards, like a 6 and a 5 and a 3. Actually... A 3 would have been fine, and a 5 would have been fine.
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm just talking words.
Isn't your job to analyze poker
hands?
No,
that's not my job at all.
Are you a pet therapist? Jonathan Levy.
How did it make you feel when the bird did that? Go on, make your joke.
Jonathan Levy, PhD. Pet healing doctor.
I got that online. University of Phoenix online.
Yeah.
My PhD.
Yeah, pet healing doctor degree. He's a pet therapist. If you have a sad cat or an over-anxious dog, just contact Jonathan.
our Twitter handle is 2PokerGuys, at the number 2PokerGuys. Yeah.
He doesn't do iguanas. He has.
No.
He had
no.
an incident.
Really cold-blooded creatures at this point. It only in special cases, I'll say that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not going to be racist against cold-blooded creatures, but only in special
for
cases.
For a friend, he'll do it.
Yeah.
Cantu raised blind under the gun.
All right.
Action Aaron with nice suited look. Oh, Cantu raised blind and he has two kings.
Wow. Action Aaron with the suited connector. He's probably going to raise it up.
No, just calls.
A little bit unlucky for
Cantu. Cantu's going to be very upset if it limps all the way to him and he has no option to raise.
Yep. Wonka, this is an opportunity for Wonka to raise. You'd expect him to. He's nope. going to call.
Oh, this is a nightmare.
Wow.
It's a nightmare for Cantu.
Oh, and Mintim is going to call.
And Cantu, look at his face.
Yeah.
He wanted so badly.
He reached for the chips and then had to realize he could not raise it up.
And the ace flops.
Oh, terrible
nobody,
flop.
Nobody has an ace, but.
A five would be a pretty fun card, a five of not hearts. The five of spades would make a straight and a set.
That's true.
But it's going to check through. That's got to feel good if you're Cantu when it checks through.
Nobody raised, so it's not as likely anybody has an ace.
Snuggy's got a queen.
Yep.
Cantu's going to bet here. Snuggy, I think he's going to have to call one.
This is mostly a value bet, I believe. It's not really a bluff at all. Maybe a little bit of protection there.
Yep.
But he's trying to get value out of a six or a queen.
Or a pocket pair.
Yeah.
It's reasonable. Snuggy calls, reasonably so. Would expect a call there. But it's going to be hard for Cantu to bet again, especially on that card.
I don't think he can bet the six.
No way. Snuggy doesn't love it either. He's going to check. Cantu checks it back right away and gets the win.
If the river was something like a 7 or a 3, you think Cantu would have gone for more value on the river?
Against Snuggy, I think he might have. I think he would have bet, you know, like 80 on the river.
Yeah.
Go for some value. Nice, small, very callable. Snuggy doesn't like to fold.
So there you all get to see the pitfalls of blind raising in a game that doesn't allow straddles.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have a big hand there and everybody limps. And you're like, well, that is not great. I don't like it. Although, if there were no straddles allowed and he just raised normally anyway, everybody would have just called normally anyway, I think.
Not everyone, though. Like, oh, I guess Snuggy probably would have called queen 9. Pocket 5s would have called 4-3, would have called 8-7, would have called. Okay.
So it would have played out the same.
But he would have made more money.
How?
There'd be more money in the pot?
He might have raised to 25. That's what his blind raise was.
You know, he did raise to 25. Yeah, you're right. He's been raising to 30 normally.
Yeah, 30.
You're right. It's pretty much the same. Just good to see the best hand. Sometimes people 3-bet, though, because they're crazy. So it would have been possible. Although, since no one raised
it's
anyway.
It's a lot better to 3-bet the blind raise than the known raise. But okay.
It's hard to argue.
Action Aaron, by the way. Was that a blind raise?
Yes.
I imagine it must
have.
It
has to be, right?
I mean, it is Action Aaron.
But even so. Good flop for Action Aaron.
Yeah.
I expect he's going to win right away.
Yeah, I can't see Cantu continuing here.
A lot of guys wearing dark clothes there, you know.
They're trying to match the table.
What was once Scarf Corner?
It's no Dash longer. Corner. It's Dash Corner.
Okay, and then Cantu over there also wearing black. Our dealer, Josh, wearing black. You can see his arms.
Yeah, they're going to go burgle together after the game.
Is that a thing now?
Yeah.
The poker players
do? Post-game burgling.
Yeah. The loser's going to go burgle?
Yeah. Got to make that money back.
That's right. How do you think they put themselves in this 5-10 game? This thing ain't cheap. BMW Blake, they call him that because he's great at stealing BMWs.
Yeah, he owns a 1997 Toyota Corolla.
That's right, which he stole.
Yeah.
I wonder if he's going to be upset about that.
I don't care.
Okay,
Wonka's probably going to open King 10 off in the hijack.
Yeah. Snuggy looks like he can't call fast. Wait. He can't call fast enough, except he does take his time.
Because the chips were stuck. That's the only reason.
It's true. It's a pretty straightforward call here for Action Aaron, although you never love calling with what is often a dominated ace.
Mitsuf called King Deuce suited against Wonka, by the way, which is probably not a great idea. Flops a deuce, but there's two aces out there.
Aaron has
and
the best
Snuggy.
Hand.
And Wonka has a 10.
Everybody has something. Everybody's got a pair. Action Aaron looks like he's going to donk it.
This is typically not going to work out so well for him, but in this scenario, it's going to work perfectly.
Yep. I don't know. With all those people behind him, Wonka is not loving that. Wonka was going to check for sure and play it as a check call.
There's no flush draws.
With two people behind him, I don't know if he's going to want to call this.
There's no open enders. It's just gut shots as draws, so it's... Wonka might be thinking Aaron's going to dunk a hand like 9, 10, or Jack 10, and he's ahead of that. But then he's got two players behind him as well.
And as you see, Snuggy does have an ace. Also, Wonka trying to stay out of those marginal situations, and he does once again correctly.
Shouldn't have opened that king 10 off. What a fool.
I was rooting for a 10 or a king on the turn, I'll tell you what.
That would have been
amazing. Just to hurt him a little bit. Action Aaron.
Is he going to keep betting?
When you get called by Snuggy, I think you are supposed to keep betting here.
Snuggy does have 9, 10 in his range here.
Okay. But you know what else he has? A lot of other stuff.
Yeah. Snuggy quickly calls.
I expect this to go check a lot.
Yeah, Snuggy has the nut flush blocker. He could turn his hand into a bluff if he wanted to be super cool.
Why would he do that?
Because it's fun.
His hand's
Aaron's
a little...
bet twice. What does he have?
I don't know. Aaron bets with a lot of things, man. Aaron could be betting a 10 all the way. Come on. It's Aaron. He could also be betting a bluff all the way.
Yeah, that's possible.
Aaron could absolutely have like 3-4, 4-5.
The eight's going to play.
Yeah. It always feels good if you're action Aaron.
Yep.
Takes away some of the pain.
The pain that... What pain?
The pet pain.
Oh.
I know. Everything I see these days is through the filter of pet emotions.
I was going to say something like that, and I got to be honest with you for a second. I'm going to use this public forum to be honest with you.
This is a great time for some authentic sharing.
It's starting to get to everybody when, like, like when my wife came home from work crying, and you were like, you know what a parrot would do? She didn't like that so much.
Well, I didn't say, in fairness, I didn't say you know what a parrot would do. I said you know what helps parrots in this situation.
Yeah, which is crackers. And then you threw some crackers at her face.
Yeah, I mean, I've really seen, I mean, to be fair, I've seen a lot of birds respond very well to that. And when I say birds, I mean specifically parrots.
Yeah, of course. All right, meanwhile, Terminator is going to open 10-8 off. Plus one. Terminator is terminating right now.
Yeah.
Snuggy, is he three betting or just calling?
He's going to call the jack eight.
Snuggy's doing what Snuggy does, and Terminator is doing what Terminator does.
Snuggy has Terminator dominated somehow, and we can make some serious straights with this.
Blake
this
has
spot
a
here.
Legitimate hand.
It's going to be some a lot of fun flops.
I mean, everybody's sharing flops that they like.
Right. But
not that one, though.
The problem is they also have each other's cards.
Yep. Whoever's aggressive here, which is usually Terminator, is probably going to win this hand. Snuggy does some weird floating sometimes, but...
He usually has, like, backdoor nut draws.
Yeah,
stuff.
Something.
He doesn't have anything like that.
Yeah.
It's just the eight of hearts. Sorry, the ten of hearts? Whatever it was.
He had the jack eight with no hearts.
You know,
Terminator has the eight of hearts in his hand. It's on the screen.
You know, I was just thinking about what a... an orangutan would do in that situation.
You
and I, when I said, I mean emotionally, not of course what they would actually
all right
do physically.
Now you're just trying to self-aggrandize here because everybody knows you're not on the level where you're treating orangutans
okay
yet.
Okay, I've been studying
domestic
it.
Legal pets. That's all you've done so far. I know it. You can't get that past me.
Listen.
You've never even met an orangutan.
But that is not the point. I said, I'm thinking about what one would do, though, in the situation. I can have read about that and be thinking about it, preparing for when I eventually do work with orangutan.
Which is orangutan.
Yeah, that's plural.
All right, is Terminator going to open this one
no
under the gun? I
no
mean, he opened worse hands. He understands reverse implied odds, so that's a reason not to. Mitziff's going to open two sevens here.
An actual hand worth opening.
And Aaron's going to call without even sitting down because that's just cool.
Yeah, it looks like he was maybe taking a little bite to eat, probably some crackers.
That's mostly what mammals and birds eat. All right, we got heads up. Action Aaron has jack
well
three offsuit.
At least he has the button.
Yeah, at least he has that.
And you know, he likes to play. He gets to play this way. Jack in the window. Oh,
and a three.
Top two. Sorry, top and bottom. Close enough.
Mitziff is going to feel pretty good about this flop also.
Now, I think if you're Action Aaron, you could raise right away because of your rep.
Yeah, I think so.
I think it's not crazy to raise right away. This is a pretty safe board, though. There's the only thing you don't want to see is a four.
You get value from overpairs and other jacks when you raise.
Yeah.
And sometimes they're not going to believe you because you're Action Aaron. And it looks like...
Look at that.
Mitziff's calling right away with two sevens.
Mitziff has no interest in folding Action Aaron, clearly.
Ace on the turn.
Interesting card.
Mitziff is going to lead.
I was assuming Mitziff was going to check, and Aaron was probably going to keep betting. There's no way he's going to fall that action, Aaron. He's going to need a four or an ace.
So Mitziff is repping like ace-king here or something like that?
Which, of course, isn't good anyway. Mitziff going to bet again after getting called. He's trying to get Aaron, I guess. Oh, look at that. He's really
trying to fold
it.
Aaron off of just a jack, not,
like jack,
not jack. It's hard for him to imagine Aaron has jacks up here. But this isn't going to work out for Mitziff, obviously, because Aaron flopped way too well to fold. That would have probably worked against jack 10.
Yeah, I guess it probably would have. It's a bit of a fishy line, but it still probably would have worked.
Hey guys, we're going to get right back to the action, but we got to take a moment and tell you about Dash Digital Cash.
Dash Digital Cash is an awesome cryptocurrency. It has instantaneous transactions. It has super cheap transactions. I'm talking about one penny. That is insane. It's very useful. It should be adopted by everybody. And to start adopting it, you go ahead and download the Dash wallet by using the links in the description of this video.
Yep, it's fantastic. If you want to know more about Dash, we actually made a 5-minute video explaining all the benefits, how it works and everything. It's right up here. So you can check that out too. Otherwise, let's get back to poker time.
All right, we're back, and man, that was a big pot Mitziff just lost. We're taking a pretty bluffy line with a hand that had value on the flop, and he turned it into a bluff when the ace came. That was pretty cool, but...
It's cool, but at the same point, when we talk about Wonka avoiding marginal spots, if Wonka has two sevens and he gets raised, he probably just folds on the jack high board.
Yeah.
Probably just doesn't want to get involved. Instead, Mitziff lost four streets really worth of value.
Yeah.
He got raised, and then two more streets after that.
Got a little cute.
Yeah. You know, like we said, though, that's going to work a lot against certain hands.
I mean, against Jack 10, it's probably going to work.
Yep.
Speaking of Jack 10, Snuggy's got that. He's going to limp it.
It's going to work for Snuggy.
I mean, sure. Until Mitziff makes it 50.
So is this a tilt raise or is this just a snuggy limp raise?
It's both. I think it's a little bit of both.
I think it's a little bit of both too.
It's reasonable to raise a snuggy limp when you have an ace, but it's not a very good ace and it's offsuit.
You're plus two.
He just lost a big pot where he bluffed and got called, so I think the tilt is probably a factor here.
I think so too.
He flops a three. Snuggy flops nothing.
Checks it right back.
Showdown value. Doesn't want to get raised.
Right away we're in bluff catching mode.
Well, we're not going to be able to catch a bluff. We're going to be able to catch value.
Snuggy checks again. I guess he feels like he can't get value very often. And that's a brick, more or less, on the river. I expect Snuggy to go for some value.
Yeah, he's got a bet now, right?
And Mitziff, it's a weird spot. Like, he's been playing this the whole way to call here. It's reasonable to call. Snuggy definitely doesn't have to have it.
I mean, that board is all over Snuggy's limp calling range, though.
You have bottom pair. Snuggy could reasonably be betting an 8 or even a 7 for value.
Yeah, I think we have to fold here.
Oh, it looked like he was going to throw it away, but he makes the call. It's not impossible to make this call or anything when you've been playing it this way, but...
But how often is Snuggy going to check twice and then bluff the river? That's usually not a bluffy line. People tend to start bluffing earlier than that.
They do. When you're out of position, though, it's a little bit tougher. A 10 came. A 10 is slightly better for Mitziff's range, I would say. Slightly better.
I disagree.
It's a Broadway card.
I think it's a neutral card.
Okay, I guess that's fair. That's fair to call it a neutral card.
The board is better for Snuggy's range, for
no
sure.
No question. No question.
Well, a little tilty there.
If indeed that was tilt, Mitziff felt the financial pain of tilt.
Yep. As many have.
Yes. As many have. Many animals have. I've seen that in my work.
Yeah, I'm sure you have.
PhD, man. Snuggy going to play this one.
The limp fest continues for the Snugster.
Cantu.
The Snugster. That's a... Felt wrong saying that.
Yeah. Cantu looks like he's going to make the world's best limp if Action Aaron's going to limp behind or play behind even with slightly worse diamonds.
He's going to raise.
Okay.
The world's best limp.
I don't know.
That's quite a claim.
It really is. That's way too much. Oh, if Digital Dan could have been there with diamonds too and diamonds came, can you imagine?
I can't even begin to.
Then it would have been the world's best limp. Now it's just a mediocre limp.
All right, Terminator's got ace-10. He's going to play. Snuggy obviously staying in there. And we've got five-way action.
In truth, Cantu limping here is probably just a more boredom. And
yeah.
Like, I haven't really got anything to play, so I'm playing this hand, right? It's not really the world's best limp.
No, certainly not. Flops a pair, but
so
Action,
does Action Aaron
also flops for so does Terminator.
Yeah, Terminator's got the actual hand here. As Terminator, are you going to donk it? I guess the answer is yes. Not impossible to do it on this board five ways out of position. I don't hate this.
You're not getting raised by anything but a set, so you can comfortably bet fold.
Well, two pair. Two pair can raise you.
Yeah, I guess two pair is
10-7 suited.
Okay, that's fair. I wasn't really imagining that, but that totally makes sense with these guys.
Someone could raise a draw also, like 5, 6, or 8, 9.
They could.
But
I think you can comfortably bet fold anyway.
That's fair.
Over pairs aren't going to be able to raise you.
BMW Blake has a pair and two back doors. Gets to close the action, but...
Maybe if Aaron had folded, he would have called.
He's got to save that gas money up, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Doesn't get very good gas mileage.
Because of BMWs.
Well, he would have hit one of his back
draw.
Doors.
He's going to check. Action Aaron makes some interesting choices in these spots. Sometimes he'll bet here.
He could bet small to try to get a cheap river.
Yeah. Cheap showdown.
Cheap showdown, yeah.
Well, this may help him get
a cheap
showdown.
I think we're just
going
to go check here pretty much every time. And Terminator gets to win.
Terminator's got to love it when Aaron checks it right back twice.
Decent sized pot there.
Considering.
Considering what?
Well, if you consider the GDP.
Of what?
Just the GDP.
Just generally?
I mean, yeah, if you just think about the GDP.
Economic principle, yeah.
No, not as a principle. The actual GDP.
Of what?
Of, you know, the things that have it.
All right. No, you got me. It makes sense.
You know what GDP stands for, right?
Gross domestic product.
Yeah, I was hoping you were going to say something different. That was funny. Like when you did PhD.
Yeah, before. I couldn't quickly come up with one.
Well,
that time.
Okay.
I took like some time while I was talking to
PhD. Good. You saw it coming, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, the PhD one. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was quite good. Pet healing doctor. I mean, it's true. I guess that makes it easier.
Yeah.
Obviously, there are pet healing doctors. There are pet therapists and things. You know?
There are.
Those things are real. Terminator. He's on the button. I can say that.
Wonka's got a pair here. Is he going to limp or raise?
He's going to complete. Just looking to flop a set.
Snuggy gets to see a free flop with a hand that can flop pretty well, although Dan blocks a lot of that.
Well, you can make straights though and things like that.
Mitsuf flops middle pair.
That's it.
That's really it. Nobody's got a flush draw. Nobody's got a straight draw.
This is just usually going to work out, right?
Yep.
There's too many people in this hand for these guys to make calls. Too many people behind them.
And maybe that'll get Mitsuf off tilt, but probably not.
Dash Digital Cash. Soon, when I say soon, sometime in the next half hour or so, we are going to name this week's Dash Digital Cash Hand of the Week. Whoever the winner is, you got to write that down so you can send it in with your tweet when all four episodes have been released and be eligible to win one full Dash, current value about $600.
Yeah, and you can buy some of those Dash glasses with it.
Yeah.
I think those are like $5.
I think they're even free.
Yeah.
If you know where to go.
They might be.
I know we got them for free.
Cantu with a blind raise again, and Action Aaron's got a pretty hand.
Interesting. Action Aaron, when he had the suited connector and Cantu had kings, limps. Now he's got a suited connector. He raises.
He's got a read on Cantu's blind hands.
That's
somehow
useful, let me tell you.
Snuggy's going to make an ambitious call here. He's only got five in the pot. He's calling 7-8 off.
Yep. He likes being out of position because it's the first bluffing position.
I've heard that one before.
You know who said that?
LOL.
Gus Hansen says that, and he's not even joking. He means it sincerely.
Well, yeah.
Let's see. Oh, Snuggy's going to donk this. You know what? If Snuggy's going to flat, I think he should be donking on boards like this.
Yeah, I mean, Aaron has a bunch of queens in his range. That's a bit of a problem.
Okay, he has a bunch of not queens in his range, though. Like, a lot more not queens than queens, right?
Yes. Yes,
so
I mean, this is going to work.
It just has to work a fair amount of the time. It's definitely going to. It's going to work enough of the time when you bet 120, I think. All right, you know what? That makes this call much, much better from first Snuggy than if he just called
and
then
show it
and played fit or fold. You know, that would have been really bad, I think.
Yeah, I agree.
That'd be like a massive losing play. But if it's like he's going to take shots on boards that are better for him than for Aaron and tough for Aaron to call unless he has a very particular part of his range, pretty great.
Well, he showed the bluff. I don't know if he needed to. I think people already know.
He's trying to loosen people up so when he has it, he gets called. So he can just show him the nuts.
Helmuth style.
Just like Snoop Dogg. Show him the nuts.
What?
Oh, is that... R. Kelly shows him the nuts.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Really?
Anyway, Action Aaron blind raises.
You don't know what I'm talking about?
I don't, actually.
You know about R. Kelly?
Oh, that.
I went from one kind of joke to another.
I thought you were referring to a song. Now we went to a dark place. Anyway, Terminator's going to raise it up with 7-8 off. Taking a different approach than Snuggy with a 7-8 off. Equally loose. Maybe a little bit less loose. Snuggy has an unknown hand on the button, and I really mean unknown.
Well, I expect Terminator will continue heads up here on that board.
Yeah, I think it would be reckless not to.
Snuggy just throws it away, whatever it was. I can assume it was crappy.
I think Snuggy's the type of player, this is my read on him at this point, where if he gets a bluff through like he did last hand and he got to show it, he's a lot more likely to play the next hand than he would otherwise be.
That's fair.
He's having fun at that point. You know, he wants to play.
People play poker for different reasons, for sure. Not everyone's playing like... I think Wonka's playing to win the money.
Well, he is a professional poker player, so he needs to be playing for that reason.
I mean, not all professionals play just to win the money, but I think Wonka probably is. He cares more about that than anything else, and so he makes decisions that are always going to be about that. A lot of people aren't doing that. A lot of people are doing it for other reasons, and so they're making different kinds of decisions. BMW Blake?
I think by definition, professionals are playing to win the money.
I don't know if that's entirely true. They should be, but that doesn't mean they are.
Okay. Dan makes a tight fold. I think it's because Blake made it 60 under the gun. And
nobody
had done any blind raising or anything.
Are we sure Action Aaron didn't blind raise?
Yeah, because Action
Aaron did the hand before.
Action Aaron is the big blind.
This is very strange. Yeah, look, he folds out King Queen suited, 10-9 suited.
No, 10-9 suited calls.
Oh, never mind. Still, that is fascinating to have made it 60. You think that was a mistake? Maybe
I think he got that number in his head based on the blind raising and then didn't adjust when he kind of didn't pay attention to see if it was a blind raise.
That or he accidentally took an extra green chip.
Yeah, that's possible
there.
Too.
Either one of those
I'm
things.
I'm watching you carve out your raise over there.
And Aaron calls with 7 deuce off.
Wow. Well, he's closing the action, Grant. So that's good. A deuce is good if he
hits it. My theory is that those glasses obscure his vision.
For which guy?
Aaron.
Well,
the one who called with 7 deuce.
I maybe you meant Blake, who bet 60.
Obviously, Aaron has the best hand now. We all knew that was going to happen.
Now, Blake has got to play this hand in an inflated pot.
He's going to check it.
Go ahead.
Check. Snuggy checks it. Aaron is winning. Let's see if that continues.
It continues.
It does. It's a scary card. Nobody has.
Aaron bets.
That's a. I mean, he's right. He's got the best hand here, but man, that's a scary card to bet on. I guess.
Yeah. Usually, though, one of these two guys would bet their flush draws.
Yeah, that's true.
Aaron's the most likely guy to have a flush.
Is that a bluff or what is that?
That's a great question.
I guess it's protection?
It's a bet. It's probably a bluff. Right? You're probably trying to fold out like 2 8s if
you think a pocket pair will fold there. Most of the time.
If it checks through on the king high board and then the heart comes and Aaron bets. Well, Aaron betting, a pocket pair is going to have to think about calling, but.
But Aaron is the guy who has the most flushes in his range.
No question. No question.
By like a huge margin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Snuggie and Blake are almost always going to bet their flush draws. Which is why sometimes you should check your flush draw, by the way.
Yeah.
To mess up people.
King Queen again for Digital Dan. This time he's not facing a $60 raise.
No one 6X'd it.
And he's going to just limp it.
That makes it easy for Terminator to come along.
You can make a straight flush with this hand.
So can Snuggie.
Snuggie's a little bit Snuggie.
Everyone says that.
Mitziff, definitely off tilt, raising to 55 with Jack 8 offsuit.
I think Cantu's going to put in a big raise here.
Looks like it. I see black chips in his hand.
Yep. Too many players to play Ace Queen against.
He's also probably aware of Mitziff's current state. And this is just going to work, I think.
Yeah.
And that's a nice free pot for him. $100.
Yeah, no need to deal with anything. You're going to. That's actually the kind of hand against that many players, too, where you can flop top pair and lose a big pot.
Yeah.
Right? Because you're playing 5 players or something like
that. Just calling there, you're going to have to proceed with a lot of caution unless you flop monstrously.
The problem, of course, is the converse, I should say, is you make that raise and then Mitziff re-raises and now you have to throw your hand away a lot.
It sucks. It sucks to 3-bet fold a value hand, but sometimes when you're deep enough, it's okay.
Yeah. First thing you have to worry about is isolation.
Yeah.
And then you worry about, now I'm up against the part of his range that I'm doing very badly against.
Yeah.
Yeah. That happens to me with queens sometimes in tournaments.
Right.
It's like you have to 3-bet big because to isolate, and then the under the gun raiser puts in a huge 4-bet.
And you're
the kind of person who always have it, and you just have to fold.
All right, Terminator is going to terminate. Wonka's going to set mine. Snuggie's going to queen 6 mine. Digital Dan with a pretty one in the big blind, although Terminator blocks a lot of the good stuff that can happen.
Doesn't just block it. If they were both get hearts, it would be Terminator.
Yeah.
Disaster for Digital Dan. We start calling him Disaster Dan. Digital Disaster. Something like that. I don't know. We're still working on it.
Like Quickster?
Is that anything? It's sort of like that. Snuggie flops the flush. Wonka flops the set.
Wow, this is going to be fireworks.
Let's go. Let's see. So Snuggie only with $900 behind.
Does he raise right away? I mean, Wonka is repping a lot of strength here when he is not the original raiser and leads this board.
That's true.
Snuggie just calls.
It's okay to just call here with the second nuts, though. In
it
position.
Is. But what's the bottom of Wonka's range there? Ace queen with the queen of clubs? I mean, we know Snuggie has the queen of clubs.
It could be ace jack
with
jack clubs.
Wonka fills up, and Snuggie's going to lose his whole stack pretty much every time now, right?
Yeah, I mean, even if Wonka goes bet, you assume he's going to be able to shove the river, or Snuggie's going to move in on the river for whatever's left.
Unless the ace or the 4 pairs.
That's right, or the 9 pairs.
Yeah.
I mean, if the board pairs again in any way, then I guess then I would trip up.
Or another club might kill a bit of Wonka's action.
Yeah, actually, there are cards that could do it. If you're Snuggie, it's actually a reason to move in.
That looks like what he's doing.
That's reasonable for all the reasons we just said.
Easy call, and Snuggie's drawing dead.
Yeah. Let's see his reaction. There you go. There it is.
Well, he's not happy with the situation.
Nope.
I wouldn't be either.
See, that's exactly the kind of card that could have been an action card killer. It wouldn't have been.
It wouldn't have
but
been.
But it could have been. They both would have thought it would be an action killer, right?
They would have, yeah.
That's why you want to bet the turn and raise the turn as Snuggie, and it makes sense to do so.
That's just a cooler.
Yeah. Snuggie should be glad he only had, $900 in front of him when that happened, because they had more. Wonka would take longer to make the call, but he wouldn't have folded full house on that board.
It was a cooler that didn't have to happen, though, because Snuggie didn't have to play queen 6 suited preflop.
But
you know?
Snuggie gonna Snuggie, that's his thing, and he's gonna win pots that no one else would win except maybe Action Aaron and Terminator, and he's gonna lose pots like that too, which some players like Wonka are just gonna be able to avoid.
Yep, that's true.
Snuggy gonna snuggy. Let's get a t-shirt that says that.
I don't want to.
All right. But, I mean, it would be funny.
Well, that was Wonka's got the same hand.
Gonna have to play it, right? You just want a huge pot.
Unless sometimes the table tells us a lie and gives the guy that won the pot the same hand as last time.
Nah. No, see, Mitsu didn't have that hand last time.
He is raising.
This is the real deal.
Cantu's got ace king.
He's going to call this time. Interesting.
I guess it's a different hand, right? Because the four of clubs was out there. So it is a different two fours for Wonka.
There you go. Well, if Wonka can do it again, that would be amazing.
Well said.
Thanks.
Cantu just calls, by the way, and he flops pretty well, but it is a slightly dangerous board against these players.
A jack would make the nuts for Action Aaron, and not heart jack, anyway. Cantu, of course, going to bet. Let's see what kind of action he gets here. Looks like Aaron is going to call.
Is Terminator going to overcall with the jack nine here? Yeah, he is. Wonka's going to get out of the way.
Also, the jack of hearts in his hand. Got two back doors along with second pair. It's reasonable. Brick on the turn. Let's see if any more action happens.
I think Cantu can comfortably continue betting because he didn't get raised. Nobody really has two pair very often.
This is a super brick also.
Yeah, he gets to charge all the draws. He gets to get value out of worse kings.
Yep, he just bet 200, and there you go. He's doing all the things you just said. Mainly charging the draws, I think. Terminator, this now it's going to be tough to continue. Because Cantu decided to bet again. But Terminator, a non-believer, I guess he sees all the draws that Cantu can have.
He doesn't want to believe.
One of the draws comes in.
That might be an action killer.
Let's see if Cantu decides to bet again or not. Jack 10, of course, gets there.
Terminator is often going to lead the river when he improves. We've seen him do it many times.
Yeah,
but
Cantu may not know that.
He's also just worried that it's just too hard to get value from Horse Hand at that point.
And it's probably true. Yeah. I don't know if Terminator's going to call a big bet on the river. It's a very reasonable check back there. By Cantu.
Yeah, and flatting preflop earned him a much bigger pot than he would have had otherwise. But, you know,
yeah,
there's merits to three betting, obviously.
Of course. Well, there's a lot of danger when you do this. Just like we were talking about the ace-queen. You're
going
to have to play a lot of hands with a hand like ace-king or ace-queen that doesn't play super well multi-way.
Slowing down.
That ended up being a nice situation where he could really comfortably bet the turn even though it feels like a wet board.
It's so nice when a brick comes off in those spots. You can just bet it.
He's got a pretty hand here. King, queen of clubs. I like it.
30. Fold.
Wonka's the only possible defender, but
a lot of the players at this table will call the jack six off there, but not Wonka.
Yeah. Like Iron Fist, he's the weakest of the defenders.
Ugh.
Come on. Nothing for that? That was impressive. That's a Netflix joke. No?
Yep.
Like Iron Fist?
Oh, my God.
The weakest of the defenders.
So tired of that stuff.
Oh, you just hate superheroes in general.
Yeah, they're getting really on my nerves these days.
You're going to
text him how my luck is.
You're going to love Black Panther.
It's probably pretty good. I've heard
it's pretty
really good.
It's pretty good, but you'll hate it because you hate all that stuff.
Well, Cantu has a pretty good hand in the blind raise again.
The digital one with the trays, the crabs, the threes, pocket threes, wired threes, pair.
Raise to 75.
Mitsiv did not make it 775.
It says 775. That would be cool.
That's 1 7 too many, though.
Yeah. It's just
and Cantu with a 750 call, also untrue. He just called the 75 raise. Why is Mitsiv doing this, do you think? Why is he three betting to...
We got a 3K pot here, Jonathan.
All the numbers are wrong.
Yeah. It's just
don't worry about it, people. All the numbers are wrong. It's a $75 raise, and everyone called. So it's $375 in the pot, not almost $4,000. And everyone's much, much deeper than they are. Oh, graphics guy, what happened to you? Actually, and Mitsu flaps best.
He does. Top. But it's hard to get value from worse at this point.
That's okay if there's $4,000 in the pot. No, the pot's big enough, though, in reality, that it's fine anyway to just take it down. Like I said, there's $375 in there. It's a bet's less than half the pot on a wet-ish board. BMW Blake thinking about something here. It does have two back doors and overs, but lets it go.
Digital Dan has a pair.
but
can't,
no.
Can't really call.
And Wonka's going to fold.
Yep.
And that is the hand, people. If you're participating in the contest to win one dash, Mitziff is your answer for episode 3.
Yep. Only one episode left. Make sure you get all four answers when you tweet it in at 2PokerGuys. It's very exciting. One dash going to go to one winner. We're going to randomly pick from people who have correct entries.
Yep. Check out the description of the video for more details.
Yep. Or our Twitter feed. We are at 2PokerGuys. That's the number 2PokerGuys. We're giving away a dash. It's so much money. We're just giving it away.
We're
dash
crazy.
Dash is real cash. You see it right there. We are.
We're crazy people.
Yeah. We don't want that money. We want other people to have it. Digital Dan doesn't like money, apparently, because he folded the 8 deuce off.
I think you're wrong.
That's why they call him Digital Dan.
Because he doesn't like money?
Because he hates money.
Well, we got a bunch of garbage here. Mitziff has an ace, I suppose. Terminator has a connected-ish hand. It's fine. And that's a good flop for Terminator.
Yeah, that would be the whole kit and caboodle. And can't do with middle pair decides to bet.
Mitziff
totally
might get to get away from this if Terminator raises. And yeah. That'd be nice for him.
As Terminator, do you want to raise or do you want to call? That's the only question. He decides to call. And Mitziff gets away from it anyway.
In this spot, calling is superior. I think raising might be better overall.
Mm-hmm.
Terminator picks up a gut shot to a higher straight. Oh, my God.
Cantu's going to bet again. That's surprising.
Well, now he's turning his hand into a bluff, it seems.
I think he's trying to charge a straight draw.
Yeah.
And also he knows that Terminator can be calling with sixes and things like that.
And Terminator does raise.
And it's an easy decision for Cantu. Brandon folds quickly. Doesn't look thrilled about it.
7 or 8 minutes.
Not a shock, bro.
No.
I'm not going to, I mean, I don't want to like mix two industries or anything, but if you were a cat and you had that look, I have a whole series of questions I could ask that would really help you. You know, just like to feel different, to feel better about
yourself.
It's like
yourself. A Socratic method with cats. You just ask questions. And
essentially.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know, you have to be listening to what they say and be responsive, obviously, to their,
sure.
to their cues. But yeah, you know, you're trying to see, trying to understand what's really going on underneath the fur.
Is that the title of your book? Self-published book?
Underneath the fur. It sounds like it's a very, it's the kind of thing Anthony Weiner might have written.
Actually, Aaron looks like he's going to raise with his ace out of the big blind here.
It's reasonable.
Terminator has limped the king-8 suited. I don't see Terminator folding.
Nope.
Aaron only made it 30, so.
Never. It wasn't going to fold probably unless it was like 60 or 70. Terminator doesn't like to fold.
Well, he flops an open-ender and backdoor flush draw. Aaron flops middle pair. This is the same flop as last time.
Yeah. Aaron is going to continue, and there's no way Terminator is going to fold on this flop. Is he raising? He is raising. Did he click it back? He clicked it back. Wow.
Well, he's going to get to see a free river card
exactly.
by clicking it back.
He made it much cheaper for himself.
Well,
if he doesn't fire here, it's going to be, he's really going to save some money.
Yeah, he is. But Aaron sometimes will lead in strange spots.
This is a spot where you could consider leading because you'd be worried that Terminator might check back. That means Terminator was only raising with one pair, though. Aaron is going to lead. Oh, the best laid plans of mice and men.
It's the second episode in a row you've said that, I think.
Really?
Or maybe it was on the Sydney
no,
show
I,
you said
I
that.
I said it somewhere else, yeah. I like saying it because the book is wonderful. Lenny, you know, what happens to Lenny at the end? It's heartbreaking.
Well, Aaron does not get to win anymore off of Terminator there. Terminator probably does not win or lose the minimum there, but he was attempting to get himself a free river card, which is often going to work if Aaron doesn't improve.
If it isn't an ace or a seven, Aaron's going to check almost always, we have to believe.
Yeah.
And Terminator's got a great chance to check or try and steal the pot. Either one is going to be great. You know, he goes, if he fires twice more, he might win even if he doesn't improve. It's going to be a tough call for Aaron.
The digital one hasn't played for a little while, but hasn't had anything. Terminator has played and hasn't had anything.
There's that king eight of hearts again. This time Snuggy has it. See if he flaps an open ender too.
A lot of garbage heading to this flop.
Ouch.
10 high flop would hurt a little bit for Blake.
All hearts.
What? That would be sick. Well, that's Terminator's got the 10 of diamonds and a 7, so that's a decent flop.
Best hand, best draw. He looks like he's going to bet it. Oh, he's going to bet as small as he possibly could, but it's not going to matter.
He's just going to end things. Well, no, he bet 15.
Oh, he did? Okay.
He's having a good time. He's happy to win with his 10-7.
He's playing poker, man. People love to play poker.
Yeah, but a lot of people, I think, play poker to become angry. Like, they go with the specific intention of finding something to complain about. And Terminator's not one of those guys.
He is not. That's true.
I know a lot of those guys.
I feel like you're saying people play poker to find something to complain about. I think they're just walking around in life looking for things to complain about, and then they happen to be playing poker and doing it, right? It's just a paradigm.
Yeah.
This, you know, if you read chapter 3 of the pet book that I'm that's coming out next week.
Under the Fur.
Under the Fur, yeah, coming from Random House.
No, it's self-published.
No, Random House with a K at the front. Right? Okay. You know, it's a silent K. So it's my own.
Terminator raises with a pretty hand here.
Yeah.
10-9 suited. Wonka is going to mostly set mine, I think.
The problem is he kind of needs other people in. I guess he doesn't. It's only $40.
Yeah.
They're deep enough. He can profitably set mine. Also, sevens, sometimes he can call down with a little bit anyway.
Certain flops, yeah.
Digital Dan, going to have to get involved.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's good enough from the big blind.
Sure.
Nine high flop with a seven on it. Let's go.
All spades.
Well, there is a seven.
And an open ender for the Terminator.
There will be fireworks.
Yes.
This is the second set that Wonka's flopped.
In this episode. And he's got a chance to get some serious money out of it, assuming he holds, which is not a done deal.
I am betting he'll raise right away. There are draws out there.
It's a pretty wet board.
There's a lot of one pair and two pair hands that can call him.
Yeah. I think you're probably right. This makes sense to raise it up. Because there are so many bad cards.
I think he's just considering the sizing that he's going to choose here.
Let's take a look.
How does he get all of Terminator's stack is what he's wondering.
That is a call.
He's just calling. He's trying to keep Dan in with a one-pair hand, I guess.
He also is aware that Terminator can not have it and keep firing and maybe wants to
that
get a chance
for sure
to do
happens
that.
At the same time.
This is
working beautifully. He gets Dan to call with a backdoor nut flush draw
and
backdoor
straight. Wow, that's a questionable call there.
And it's a very safe card for Wonka on the turn.
I think Wonka probably really hated once Dan called. Oh, but Terminator's going to move right in, and
well,
that makes it easy for Wonka.
Wonka's probably going to reship it just to isolate. Make sure Dan folds his flush draws.
Yeah. Yeah, make sure Dan is... No, like, even a combo draw wouldn't be getting the right price if Wonka moves in. But if Wonka just calls, it's close.
Yep.
Dan could decide with an overcard. He could call ace-ten of clubs, king-ten of clubs, things like that.
Wonka's just deciding between a call and a ship, I think.
I think he's moving in. I think he's just trying to make it look like he doesn't know what he's doing. Yeah, they just said raise. Dan only has a click back anyway, yeah. Dan just has to fold because of that. All right, well, this is not over by any means. Seven outs for the Terminator to scoop this pot.
Wonka doesn't love it. He would love to be against aces here.
True, but still, pretty good spot. And he's going
to
hold.
He gets to hold.
Digital Dan would have made a pair.
And I guess that's going to do it for the Terminator. Had a bit of a rough session. Wonka really coming up big this session with those sets.
Well, he had two sets, and both times his opponents just shoved right into him on the turn.
Yeah.
Pretty good deal. Pretty good deal indeed.
Ah, to be Wonka.
And we've replaced Terminator.
Yep. Although this guy, Sam, has glasses that look more like Terminator glasses.
It's true. He's also all hoodied up.
Yep. Like the Terminator in Terminator 7.
How many Terminators have there been at this point? Have there been six? I think there's been six.
I don't know.
There's been five. Terminator Genisys was the fifth one. They're doing another one, Grant.
Can't wait.
Also, if you include Sarah Connor Chronicles, the TV show, that would count as a sixth. But it's not really canon, I don't think.
Okay, so Digital Dan's going to call out of the small blind. X-Nair and raise 7-3 suited.
Double and, gutter for Digital Dan.
Yeah, Dan's going to... Definitely call at least if Aaron bets, but it looks like we went check pretty quickly there.
Digital Dan, I assume, is going to bet and win right now.
He can rep the jack really well.
But instead he checks.
Decides not to. Dan can't fold yet.
No, but now he sets himself up to be bluffed.
I would have liked to see a bet on the jack. He has a lot of jacks in his range.
Absolutely.
Plus a lot of equity. Well, he picks up a pair, and if Aaron gives up, Dan gets to win.
If Aaron doesn't give up, Dan still might win sometimes. He might decide to call.
If Aaron gave up, Dan would have won anyway with queen high. The 10 is a bad card to continue for Aaron.
Well, it's a 10 of hearts, though. Aaron can have hearts.
So can Dan.
Yeah. Actually, Dan has more hearts than Aaron, because Aaron would have bet his flush draws a lot on the flop. Yep. Although Dan might have bet him a lot on the turn,
true,
honestly.
True.
Aaron took one shot with that 7 high, and never again. I don't know if that's enough with 7 high on that board.
Yeah.
On the jack pairs. Although maybe just feels like Dan has an ace a lot and is just going to station him, which is probably true.
Very true.
Actually, fair enough. So you got to bet the flop. Find out right away.
I wonder if Dan would have check-raised the flop with the double gutter. That would have been interesting to see.
I'm going to guess he wouldn't have since he didn't raise the turn.
You mean bet the turn?
Or raise the turn. Yeah.
It seems like a bad time to raise on the turn when the jack pairs.
He can have the jack. I mean, so can Aaron.
Yeah.
They can both have a jack. Maybe Aaron has more jacks, though, actually, because he checked it back.
Yep.
Yeah. Here's Sam.
Going to play his first hand, but it is our last hand of this episode. There will, of course, be another episode next Tuesday. The conclusion of this session.
This 5-10 with Brandon Cantu session.
With the Dash giveaway session.
Yes. The final Dash giveaway hand will be revealed next episode. Need all four of them.
Well, Blake flops bottom pair, and Sam flops middle pair.
Sam is going to bet.
Well, he's continuing.
Okay.
Blake limped, and Sam raised out of the small blind.
I got all caught up on what we're talking about.
And Blake's going to raise. That is curious.
Tough spot immediately for Sam. Sam doesn't seem like it's very tough, though. He calls pretty quickly with the best hand.
Well, it's hard to imagine what Blake's raising. And that's a good card for Sam.
Yeah.
He picks up an open ender. I can't see him folding the turn unless Blake really bombs it.
Easy to be sticky here as Sam, which is nice based on the hands. Blake is going to continue. We've seen Blake before triple barrel, so if he's got three barrels in him, this might just work out.
He does have at least two.
Let's see how much he makes.
190. It's not enough to get Sam to fold.
Yeah, Sam's going to call here hoping sometimes Blake is going to give up. Sometimes he's going to miss his draws. Sometimes he's going to improve. Sam is going to improve. So those are all reasons to call. But you kind of hate it in these spots too, right?
And he does call.
So often it's bricks and you just have to fold the river.
If the turn was a deuce, I think that would have worked for Blake.
Yeah. River
Sam will not be folding at this point. The question is to lead to make sure that Blake doesn't just get to check back his big hands or to check and hope Blake is bluffing.
Yeah. I think it's a close one.
Sam's going to lead, it looks like.
It's not unreasonable just in case Blake has a set. You worry that Blake was going to check it back. However, if Blake had clubs.
Big bet of 575 on the river, hoping to get value out of a set or two pair that just can't find a fold.
He's trying to make it look like he missed his own clubs there. If Sam is going to play missed clubs like this sometimes, this could work. But I don't know if he's going to have missed clubs very often on the turn unless he has the five of clubs in his hand.
I wonder if Blake would have taken a shot had Sam checked.
I think it's very possible.
Either way, Sam gets to win the first hand he plays, a pretty big one on Poker Time, and we'll get to see more of him and all of these guys next week.
We'll see you then.